Yo, what's up, Africa? Welcome to the seventh episode of NBA Africa Game Time, the virtual edition, bringing you lifestyle, bringing you culture, and of course, bringing you the beautiful game of basketball. My name is Shoma Josie, and on this episode, we'll be hearing from OKC's Danilo Gallinari as he reflects on the 2018 Africa game. We'll also be looking back at some of my favorite plays from the 69th NBA All-Star game, which I was at. And then I'll be wrapping it up by talking to two African artists who love basketball just as much as we do and who also attended the All-Star weekends themselves. I'm talking about, from right here in South Africa, TV presenter and rapper Moozlie, and all the way from Nigeria, rapper, musician, songwriter YC. So I'm super excited about that. But in the meantime, let's get ready for some NBA Africa Game Time news. Brought to you by a world leader in the post-faith industry, I'm talking about the OCP Group. So when we talk about NBA news, there's no better place to start than with the news that NBA Commissioner Adam Silver, along with the league office, have met with the Board of Governors in order to discuss a potential return of the NBA season. Now, we know the NBA has been on hiatus since March 11th due to the coronavirus pandemic, but now a return to play plan approved by the Board of Governors has been announced. 13 Western Conference teams and 9 Eastern Conference teams will play 8 regular season seeding games, a possible play-in tournament for the 8th seed before playoffs commence, all at the Walt Disney Resort in Florida. Team training will begin in early July, with July 31st proposed as the official restart date under guidance from medical experts and public health officials. There was also news that the Naismith Basketball Memorial Hall of Fame ceremony will be postponed until 2021. The ceremony was set to take place in Springfield, Massachusetts on August 29th, and the 2020 class is one of the most star-studded lineups ever. 5-time NBA champion Tim Duncan, 15-time All-Star Kevin Garnett, and the late, great Kobe Bryant are all set to be inducted.
Kobe gives us a show and has us cheering.
However, despite the postponement, Chairman of the Board of Governors for the Hall of Fame, Jerry Colangelo, stressed that there will be separate ceremonies for the class of 2020 and 2021, stating the class of 2020 is a very special class and deserves its own celebration.
And finally, the unlawful killing of George Floyd, an unarmed black man, by Minneapolis police officers has sparked protests across the world. And many NBA and WNBA players have used their platform to highlight the issue of police brutality and racial injustice. Minnesota Timberwolves stars Karl Anthony Towns and Josh Okogie attended a press conference in remembrance of Floyd, led by former NBA player Steven Jackson. Boston Celtics guard Jaylen Brown drove 15 hours from Boston to Atlanta to lead his community in peaceful protest, stating he wanted to raise awareness for some of the injustices that the black community continues to face. Brown was joined by Indiana Pacer and fellow Atlantan Malcolm Brogdon, who has encouraged people to get educated, participate, and demand accountability.
This is the most proudly black city in the world. In the world, man. So, like, let's take some pride in that. Let's focus our energy. This is a moment. We have leverage right now. We have a moment in time. People are going to look back. Our kids are going to look back at this and say, you were a part of that.
All right, so we're back again looking at some of the most memorable NBA moments on the continent. And this week, we're looking at the 2018 Africa game with Danilo Gallinari. The Italian star currently playing for the Oklahoma City Thunder lined up with Team World and left the building as the MVP. Check it out.
I took the opportunity right away to go back to Africa, in South Africa, a country where I've never been before. And it was amazing, 10 days over there. The game was amazing. The finish was exciting. The MVP, everything was just perfect.
And the winner of the Manute Ball MVP Award is Danilo Gallinari.
The African fans were crazy. The crowd was going crazy. I remember the noise was the whole game. They were just going crazy on anything that was happening. The environment was special with a lot of famous people, front row. So it was a really cool environment. some of the guys I knew already, and some of the other guys just by playing against them. But that was a great chance for me to bond with some of them, because we spent a lot of time off the court doing a lot of activities, and we went on a safari together, and we were practicing with the kids of the Basketball Without Borders every morning. I knew Joel and Bede before, but that experience, I had the chance to get to know him better. He's a special person, not just a special player. And so it was great to spend time with him. I have some friends that live in Ethiopia. I have teammates here in OKC from Egypt. So that's another place that I want to see. Basically, if I think about the people that I know around the world and the friends that I got, just to be able to go and see them in their own country, I think is a great opportunity that I have that I'm going to use.
All right, so fans, including myself, loved the new format of the 69th edition of the NBA All-Star Game. About 7.3 million people tuned in the US alone. So now we're going to look back at some of my favorite moments from the night. We start with this icy half-court buzzer beater from Trae Young to close out a great first half for Team Giannis.
Young from center court. Yes!
Staying with Team Giannis, late in the fourth, Joel Embiid channeled one of his idols, Hakeem Olajuwon, backing down LBJ in the post, loses him with a dream shake, and then hits this turnaround jumper.
Nice fake out by Embiid, wow!
And finally, the 2020 All-Star Game MVP, Kawhi Leonard, drives down the lane and drops a dime to Anthony Davis, who finishes at the rim with a smooth reverse layup. I love it when rivals become teammates.
Leonard ducks it down low. Oh, gorgeous reverse by Anthony Davis.
Such a special night. I honestly can't wait to be back at All-Star. In the meantime, comment below with some of your favorite 2020 NBA All-Star game moments. And now I talk to two very, very good friends of mine, artists themselves and lovers of basketball. As I've mentioned before, I'm talking about Moozlie and YC, and they are the guests for this episode, NBA Africa Game Time. Let's go. It's Mr. YC.
Yo, what's good? What's good? What's poppin'?
My second guest, it's rapper Moozlie. Hey. I see you're wearing the All-Star beanie from this very most recent All-Star weekend.
Yes, from Chicago. It was super cold in Chicago, so this definitely came in handy. It was dope. 2019 was dope, but 2020 was something else.
Must be nice.
Cool. You were not going to survive the cold, my friend. It was too cold. Yeah. Like, you were not going to survive.
The cold was hectic, and of course it was a weird one because it was just after the very tragic death of Kobe.
You know, this was definitely the first time that the whole NBA had come together since the passing of Kobe Bryant and his daughter. So you just really felt the story that they had to tell about the man that he was and the contribution that he made to the NBA. It was very sad, but it was also very inspiring, you know. It really gave us all a sense that we are all in it together, that we are all one. And Kobe would want us to continue to celebrate the, you know, the spirit of the game.
Year after year, one of the All-Star teams is led by a guy with Nigerian parents. The dunk contest, you have Taco Fall now being brought onto the court and that whole stunt that happens.
This one was the hottest dunk contest that there's ever been. When he woke up in the morning, he did not know he was going to jump over this guy. He literally wrote his name in the history books, every video reel, and like forever. It's super iconic.
Yeah. In the year that we were there together, YC, they actually announced that the Basketball Africa League was something that was in the works.
The biggest moment of that day for me was, you know, just looking straight up and just seeing like Michael Jordan was in my line of sight, and I was like, oh, yo, I'm staring at him, you know. But it was a very, very, you know, memorable moment when an announcement of that magnitude was made. Having our own basketball league on the continent is gonna highlight how much, you know, that we also have like lovers of the sport. and, you know, more superstars, homegrown superstars.
That was supposed to launch middle of March, and that's been pushed back, as well as the NBA season itself.
It literally hit us all by surprise. And what's so crazy about it is that the NBA was kind of the first major worldwide organization that actually took a stand to, like, fight against the coronavirus and say, we as the NBA are actually stopping.
In terms of the African players that were playing this season, who stood out for you guys?
Obviously, a whole lot of them were shining at All-Star Weekend. To actually have African people in the All-Star game, that was, like, super, super dope.
Embiid gets position on Davis and puts it down.
LeBron, I saw him in real life and I was like, oh my gosh, I have to be Team LeBron. But then when I saw the African people, I was like, duh, I'm Team Giannis. So it was close. Obviously, Joel Embiid is dope.
Once he gets that, wow. Oh, it's a little shake and bake from Joel Embiid.
I like that kind of spice.
I think right before the season halted, Giannis was coming through, you know, game after game after game.
Here he comes again. Oh, goodness. And the basketball god raining down.
Kawhi might not be African, but for me, Kawhi as well has been a major revelation from last season, you know, winning the championship. You know, Kawhi Leonard is sort of like a Terminator-type basketballer.
Kawhi aggressive to the rim.
You know, Giannis, Kawhi, those are my boys.
Now, if they do manage to put the season back on, who's got this? Who's winning?
It's been a really tight season so far, but LeBron James and the Lakers this season, I'm gonna put some money on them.
Yeah, man, I'm gonna have to agree with him. You know, LeBron James definitely has something to prove with this season. So not only does he want to win the league, I think he's gunning for MVP. He wants to be the player that even after the break, I still maintain the consistency. I still came through and led the team to victory.
Here's James. Oh, punch it home, LeBron.
Just in terms of the players, though, there were a lot of the young guys. Zion was balling out of control.
Here we go. Lob to Williamson, and he smashes the rim.
I just want to see, like, the finesse back on the court because it was so good to see.
All right, it's time now for the Game Time quiz. YC and Moozlie on NBA Africa Game Time, naming as many former All-Stars as possible. And your 20 seconds starts now.
Michael Jordan.
Shaquille, Shaq.
Kobe Bryant, Dikembe Mutombo,
Scottie Pippen,
Dennis Rodman,
Dwayne Wade, he's retired.
Dwayne Wade, nice. Tim Duncan.
It's time. Well done, guys. You got a score of 8, which is definitely something.
That's an extra point for wearing the Scottie Pippen jersey.
I might give you a point for that because that's fire. Did you guys see Dikembe Mutombo on the, I don't know which episode it was, where they talk about the All-Star game? And, like, this guy is just there amongst, like, Jordan and all these guys, looking like the coolest guy ever, with a fade, obviously.
You know, African people have got that thing to this day. You can even, like, attest to this. When Africans are at the All-Star Weekend or whatever it is, you can just point them out in the crowd. You're like, you kind of swag about you. So the fact that he was all the way back then is pretty dope.
But thank you guys so much for joining us. Your score in the end, I'll give you 9 points for your quiz. And so thank you guys so much for joining us, and always stay home and stay safe.
Appreciate it. Be safe.
All right, guys, and that's a wrap of episode 7 of NBA Africa Game Time. As always, thank you for watching. Thank you so much to our guests, Moozlie and YC. Big shout out. Thank you for coming to join us. And of course, make sure you follow NBA Africa on all of our platforms. That's Facebook, that's Twitter, that's right here on YouTube. Make sure that you subscribe. And as always, stay home and stay safe.